goes long. It's won by Sergi. That's a great ball out left. What a ball. It was a Will Orson tries to get the end of it, but the defender just outpaces him. Scad forward. Well inside the Southeastern corner. He goes to Jordan's feet and Jordan just plays him straight back. Now he picks a ball up. Nine goes right to Jordan Chambers. Takes a great first touch at his feet. Strikes one. It wasn't a bad effort. It just sails over the bar. Nine just shift the ball out to the right hand side quickly then. Jordan Chambers pushed his first touch out of his feet. Took a shot. And just went over. It was a great effort though. Goal kick. Met by the head. A Southeastern player that heads it out for a Scad. John Chambers switches the ball. And Oliver, I'm no longer calling him the big German, as it was, he told me his mother wasn't too keen on that. And he picks up the ball again and just switches it to the Spaniard, Sergi Suarez. Sergi's still on the ball. He just goes across to Taylor Katsanas on the left side. Will drops in, plays a good ball. That's not enough on the 1-2 from Will Oswin. Now Southeastern come away with the ball. And Oliver wins the ball. It's out for Southeastern throw. I haven't been here long myself, but Southeastern aren't looking great at the moment. They're giving the ball away, and it's been easy for SCAD so far. Well, at least for the 10 minutes I've been watching. And SCAD come out with the ball again with Taylor Katsanas on the left. Plays a good ball into AJ's feet. It's a great touch and another great run. Good decision, referee. I felt like AJ was looking for that a little bit. Great sportsmanship shown there by the Southeastern player. Helps AJ up. And a long ball over the top. And that's Josh's ball. That's Will Oswin on the left side. Plays a great 1-2. There's not a lot of options forward. Great ball by Theo. And again. Theo Angus. Two great passes and Sassy comes inside. There's a chip ball over the top for Jordan, but it just runs out for a goal kick. Minutes gone, still 0-0. Scad have had the majority of the possession. Taylor Katsanas wins a great header there from the goal kick, and it's a good ball by AJ. Angus has some space to go into here. Goes left, but Sassy didn't continue his run. But Will Oswin there screaming talk. Now Oliver goes out wide to Taylor on the left side. He's looking for that run from AJ. He does find it. Good touch by AJ. I must say, it's been a pleasure to watch the last few games. Now Naeem, who seems to be a lot more involved in this game early on. That's a good ball out wide. Good feet by Taylor. As AJ's back of the ball, he just lays it back to Taylor. This is good, good patience by SCAD. Great patience. What a ball by Theo Angus. Just shifts the ball onto his right foot. Just pings a 40-yard ball straight to the in the path of Jordan Chambers. And the ball goes out for a SCAD throw. must say it's all SCAD at the moment. Southeastern can't keep possession of the ball. It's all from the high pressure of the SCAD Bees. And there we go again. Ball force to the defender of Southeastern. He just thumps it straight out for his throw deep in the Southeastern half. Go back to Sergio Suarez, who's going to play the switch to Oliver. And then surely Oliver pushes out to Taylor Katsanis. Will Oswin looking for feet. It's a great touch. Good decision, ref. Will wins a free kick there, just inside the Southeastern half. All the left footers over it here. The right foot of Theo. Head to Trinity, gets ahead, and it's a goal. John Trinity line. Great header. I personally didn't think it was a great ball in. It's just a lofted pass in, and Jordan probably headed it from 12 yards. Rises well and just pushes it towards the bottom right hand corner, and it beats a Southeastern goalkeeper. Poor positioning, if you ask me, by the goalkeeper. Shouldn't be getting beat with that. But nevertheless, don't take it away from Jordan. It was a great header. Good goal. Got himself in a good position. 1-0 to the Bees. It's good to see. 28 minutes left of the first half. Let's keep this pressure now, Scud. Their left back has just pinged the ball straight out for the corner with no pressure on him whatsoever. Keep this pressure, Scud. Will Oswin has gone over to the left-hand side to take the corner. Got Naeem going on the keeper. His hands up. Yo's gone short, but he's been trapped. Oh, and they're switching. Good idea. Chips a great ball in. Oh, it's good. What's he given? Nice, a goal kick. Took a couple of ricochets. And there's some activity on the SCAD bench, I can see. Coach Melville talking to Sun Torin and Inaki. Giving them some direction, telling them what he needs from them as they go on the pitch. Back to the play, it's a SCAD throw. Probably 30 yards outside the Southeastern goal. It's a good touch by Sergi. Carries the ball to Sese. Sese plays a good ball to AJ, who manages to keep himself onside. Back across. Oh, it was a good effort. Sergi can carry this run off.
Was by Jordan Trinity, line number.
That was a good move by the
10.
Bees.
Assisted by number 11, Jordan Theo Angus.
Defensive duties, and the ball's gone out. Sergi Suarez picks the ball deep in there. SCAD half. Out to Jordan Chambers. Plays a ball up the line, but it's just found the red shirt of Southeastern. But he's back on the ball and goes to Sese. Sese goes inside to Naeem, but he just gets dispossessed, but Theo picks up the possession. Ooh. Not sure if that was a free kick, but it's a SCAD ball, so we'll take that. We've got Will Oswin hugging the touchline out here. Well out wide, just about on the pitch. Taylor should be having this. There's no call from Taylor though. Now there's going to be a switch. Now there's going to be a switch. And there's a switch. Sassy took a slight elbow to the face, maybe. Sure, he'll be fine. Yeah, he's fine now. He's working hard to get back in. And he wins the ball back for SCAD. Well done, Cecily. Now Naeem's on the ball. Goes out to Walliver. Out to Katsanis. And there's Will on the ball. Oswin runs at the man, beats him with ease. It's a free kick. Not a bad free kick to give away, really, there by Southeastern. Will was away. So he just brings him down. Taylor takes the free kick quick to Oliver. Oliver to Naeem. Naeem goes wide. Oh, but he overhits that pass. And it goes out for the Southeastern throw. 20 minutes gone in the first half, and it remains SCAD 1, Southeastern 0. SCAD have had better possession and looked the more likely to go on and score another goal. Southeastern, I can't say they've been in the SCAD half much, and I have not seen them have one shot at goal yet. Will makes a clever little run, but oh, he's tried a Cruyff turn there, and the defender was standing 10 yards off him, so he's just like, thank you very much, Oswin. There's a switch, it could have been overhit. There it is, and that's gone into the SCAD dugout. That's the SCAD throw. Sergio Suarez picks the ball up, goes inside the field. Here goes to Jordan Chambers. And it's a touch of Josh Brown. Probably his first one in the probably 15 minutes. Finally gets a touch. Now Naeem comes very deep and picks the ball up. And he just goes to out to right. Sergio Suarez has took a right back roll this time. Goes back inside for Naeem. Sergi scoots across back into the centre half position. A little bit forced that from SCAD. It's a good idea. Taylor's time, good talking. He plays a good ball in the field. Oh, good touch by the goalkeeper. I'm not sure who'd have counted that as a back pass, to be honest. But he brings it down to his chest anyway. Now it's a left fullback for Southeastern. Chips on into the right winger. Left winger, sorry. That's enough for a Southeastern throw. But they're still pinned into their own half, Southeastern. Gone for a SCAD throw on the halfway line. Tom Melville there getting his first touch of the game. Jordan Chambers on the throw. Goes to the line to Jordan. He flicks it on with a back heel. Good feet by AJ, and he plays a good ball. Good challenge by Jordan, Trinity line. And he wins a throw in right near the right hand side corner flag. Jordan Chambers puts a great ball in. Oh, Will Oswin needed to attack that. It was a great little look from Jordan Chambers, and he played a good ball, but Oswin didn't get off the ground. And the ball ends up going out for a goal kick. Just had a substitution, SCAD substitution, the number 12, Sassy Zaretta, off, and Torin Melville on the left-hand side, right-hand side, sorry. So used to him being playing on the left with our left foot, but they're actually playing the right-hand side. Well played, Taylor. And Torin Melville gets his first touch of the game, and it's a good one as well. So unlucky with the pass. Oh, it's good battling by Will Oswin. Oof. And the cross goes all the way out for a throw. The Southeastern still pinned in their own half, and Theo wins the ball. Goes back to Jordan Chambers, who takes a good touch. No, he's not happy with that, Jordan Chambers. He feels like it should have been a free kick. The referee decides against it, and now Southeastern come out on the right wing with the ball. And they're in the SCAD half for the first time in the last 10, 15 minutes, but once again they've given the ball away. Torrin Melville picks the ball up on the wide right, plays it up, and it goes out for a throw on the halfway line. Quick throw, and the right back picks the ball up and goes back to the keeper. Keeper makes a switch out to the right fullback. Scab, deep possessable on the Angus, goes out wide to Will Oswin. He plays a nice little ball down to Taylor. Taylor's one on one with his man, what's he going to do? Good defending in the end, but it goes out for a SCAD corner. We're going to see the right foot or the left foot of Will Oswin. He always comes to get the ball, so maybe it's going to be the right foot, the in swinger. The two big boys, Oliver and Sergi, are coming up for this. Sorry, Oliver's mum, I've got to say, the big German's up. That's a good ball by Will. Oh, Jordan gets to the end of it. But unfortunately, it's more of a defensive header. Scad keep in possession. And Jordan Chambers picks it up on the halfway line. He dinks the ball over to Jordan, who wins the header. But it's just been Torrin Melville just got dispossessed. Southeastern come away with the ball. But once again, they give it away cheaply. Story of the Southeastern's first half. Keep possession for about two or three passes and then just give it straight to a white shirt. Scad back in possession with Sergi, who plays the ball inside to Naeem. Naeem casually goes outside to John Chambers. Chambers back inside to Sergi. Plays a switch out left to Taylor. Good ball into the feet of Will. Will loses his man. Referee. Oh. The referee telling the number. Oh, he's talked himself, number nine's talked himself into the book. The referee told him numerous occasions to stop talking and he didn't. So he got given the yellow card and rightly so. Good decision, referee. High one. Is the keeper going to come for that? He punches it. Southeastern just about clear their lines. Oh, Oliver. Oliver got lucky then. Oh. And it looks like AJ. Can't quite tell what he's done. He may have had one in the nuts. Yep, that's it. Here comes Daniel, SCAD physio. Don't think he's going to want much to do with it when AJ tells him it's his nuts. Yeah, Daniel keeps his hands to himself, which tells me that it was in his man bits. It's just a case of AJ taking a breather. Let that pain slowly go away. And he's up, back on his feet. He will have to go off now, but just for a minute, because the physio came on the pitch. We have 16 minutes left on the clock. In the first half, and it's still 1-0. Should it be more? Possibly, yes. But it does remain 1-0. and I'm sure we'll see more goals from the Bees tonight. I must say this Southeastern side doesn't look as good as it has in previous years. They were a little hard done by in the conference last year with a bit of conflict with Florida Memorial, who we thought were going to get suspended from the conference. Southeastern all in celebration, thinking that they qualify for the conference tournament, and unfortunately Flomo were let back in, and Southeastern were in that last spot, so they were the ones to go. They were left heartbroken. I must say, the SCAD players were very disappointed for the team as well, because they are a great team. It's a great place to go and play. One of my favourites. Great fans, great field. Anyway, let's get back to the game. It's a SCAD throw-in. Deep in the southeastern half. Story of the first half, to be honest. SCAD have played 70-80% of their football in the southeastern half, which is great to see. Jordan Chambers plays the ball to Solomon Marvel. Defender cuts it out, and it's back to a SCAD throw in with Jordan Chambers. Plays into Chunty Lyons' feet this time. Good feet. Oh, referee! Linesman. I don't think he looked across the line then, because I don't think he was off. But the flag did go up. So it's a free kick. I'm not sure if the ball boy knows what he's doing there. He's just put two balls on the pitch. Oh. That could have been dangerous to Sky. It was a long ball by the keeper. Oliver came up for the header. But he got out jumped in the header. And his flip came on. It did land at Taylor, but it was a bad touch by Taylor. And luckily, Southeastern weren't switched on enough to make more of that. Free kick to Southeastern. Just on the halfway line, basically. They just go deep. Oh, that was unlucky. The ball came long. You can hear Tom Melville, Coach Melville shouting, they were too deep, I agree. They were probably fell back into their 6-yard box. Not good enough. That's a goal kick. SCAD got away with that. James, the second ball. It's going to be a close one. But the goalkeeper gets it. Keeper was a little bit unsure, but he did manage to claim it. He's gone out to the right fullback. Naeem comes across and he ends up winning the ball back. Oh, Phil plays a great ball in. Flag stays down. That's a SCAD ball if it goes. The ref says play. Jordan gets a shot off, but just, could have been a corner. But it's a weak shot by the striker, by the number 10. Is looking fantastic tonight in his red cleats and his sleeves rolled up, looking like he means business. Hear the voice of the assistant, Coach Langford over there then, telling the defence to step up. Sure his experience has helped SCAD massively this year, just in training, just his presence in training. What a great player. They had the privilege to play with him for 3 of my years at SCAD. Great, great centre half. Richard and Brinton, the rocks. The heart of the SCAD defence. Anyway, back to the game, Tony Melville escapes out on the right hand side. Plays a great ball in. It was good defending. And as I was saying before, when AJ went off, it was Inaki who replaced him. Tony Melville plays. That's a good ball. It was good defending again. Sergius Fowler comes across. Out of the danger. Nice and easy. Now Southeastern put the ball up with a bit of space. Southeastern are in the SCAD half, but that's good defending. Jordan Chambers was good defending, he wasn't happy with his defence not getting across quick enough. And he certainly let him know. He was screaming at him. Oh, that's a bit of a bad ball from Taylor. But play on, ref. Right decision. Sergi comes across. It's a good defender. And now he blows out. Oliver stayed down. Maybe he got caught in his face. He didn't look. There was, to me, it didn't look like there was much in it. But he took a tumble, holding his face, and he's still down. But the referee's told Daniel, the physio, to stay. Daniel remains pitch side, ready to come on. A drop ball. Southeastern just roll the ball back to Josh Brown. Good sportsmanship. It's a goal kick. We have 9 minutes left of the first half. Josh goes long. Luck of a Jordan. Clever little. What are we giving here, referee? Said that Jordan gave him a little bit of a nudge. Wasn't a lot of it. Was that too happy with it? Long, something below. They lose out again. They've got to get someone winning them balls in there. Taylor comes out with the ball. Pass it to Will. Phil turns away from his man and just goes out to Jordan Chambers. The right fullback. First touch out with his feet. Plays into Phil's feet. Good feet by the captain. He just starts again. Now Naeem picks the ball up space, but he goes right. Oh, it's a clever little run by Walshman there. Now Oliver comes out with the ball. And he plays a switch and a great ball. He goes up to Jordan Chambers. Southeastern come away with a right winger on the ball. Takes his time and goes back to the right back. It's a good ball. That's a little bit from Southeastern. Oh, and he's away. It's 1-1. Oh, but he drags it wide in number 4. Lack of communication that goes down to. The defence got caught out. They got caught flat footed. Ball goes over the top. Over the left shoulder of Taylor Katsanas, and he's left 1-1, and fortunate for SCAD that the number 4 couldn't take the ball and finish it. For me, he should have took another touch, driven towards a goal. Scott get off lightly, miss a goal kick. Just goes wide to the right wing this time. Flicked on by Jordan to the line. Picked up by Theo in the centre midfield. Sergio Suarez. Camera goes out wide to Taylor. Dancing around players. Naki gets the touch. Oh, it's good football. Go on, Jordan Chambers. Pressure him, and he does, and he wins the throw-in. Good running by Jordan Chambers. Fit young lad. Never stops running. Got Philip Lamb. They're not quite as good looking. Wilson gets a cross shot off. It's close to the corner flag. And the ball boy's on the run. And chasing. Watch them snakes. That's a good ball by the right fullback. And the number 17 has managed to keep the ball in. He gets a cross in. Oh, I'll tell you what, whoever that. That's great defending by Jordan Chambers. Smallest defender. He's the one who gets himself in, gets his body in, gives him a little nudge, and puts off a striker. I'll tell you what, I don't know where the two centre halves were, and thank God for Jordan Chambers getting across right there. Just showing that he's the level he's played at back home. Just good experience there. Good defending. But more of a concern is where were the centre halves of SCAD? Something they need to sort out. And there's 5 minutes left in this first half. Wrong, SCAD have still had 70-80% of the possession, but Southeastern are slowly clawing their way back into this game. And I think it'd be better for SCAD to try and put it to bed earlier rather than letting them get back in this game. There's a sloppy ball by Taylor. And Nain comes away, he plays the ball over the top for Jordan to run down, and he gets in the end of it. He's one and one. Oh, it's a clever ball. Oh, still in his right. Oh, and it's a SCAD throw. Jordan Trinity did very well then. And it's a sub going to be for the last 4 minutes. Will Oswin is going to rest his legs up so he can get back on in the second half. And it's the number 23, Seth, who comes on. Skillful little lad. See if we can get him on the ball last 4 minutes. And this is his first touch. There's a look. Oh, it says play. I think it went out, but we'll take that. Oh, that's sloppy ball. There's long. Should be Taylor's. Taylor wins the header. As far as the red colour. As I said, Southeastern are slowly getting back in this game. There's too many times where they've been left one and one. It's good defending. That ball left Sergio Suarez one and one with the defender. With the attacker, sorry. Well played, Torin. Good battling. Very good battling by the freshman. And he plays a clever little ball and Seth stays on side. This is where we like to see him. This is where he's tricky. But he's been barged off the ball this time. And there's a little bit of fighting, got penalised with the referee, and he gives away a free kick. Southeastern free kick. Just got out muscled there a little bit. But don't be fooled, he's a feisty little lad when he gets going. Southeastern keeper goes long once again. Met by the... Oh. If Chilton Chambers comes across it. Oh. Well, I'm going to be honest, right now, the half can't come quick enough for SCAD. Southeastern are certainly getting back into this game. They're looking much better. The SCAD just need to hold out to half time and regroup. Clinty comes away. Naki on the right, screaming for the switch. But Jordan Chambers manages to get the ball up there. Good feet by Naki. Field shoot, and it's a good strike. Oh, and it's just wide of the left post. That's better for SCAD. Just over a minute left. And if you're just tuning in, it's still SCAD 1, Southeastern 0. Scad's way right now. They're losing balls in dangerous areas, especially the ones in the air. Just need to settle down a little bit, get the ball on the floor.
1 minute, 1 minute left and a half.
And as the announcers just let us know, it's 1 minute left to play the ball. Jordan Chambers, the smallest defender, and he's winning everything in the air for him, to be fair. Oh, and there's one and one. The last few seconds, stay on side. He's got, what is the number four thinking there for Southeastern? He's gone for a delicate little chip. Just put that home. It should be 1-0, and SCAD's defence got caught out once again. That should be 1-1. And now it's SCAD at the other end with Inaki. Oh, he's trying to play a ball. And that's going to be the final bit of half. What an exciting end to the half that was. Tell you what, if I was a Southeastern player, I'd not be happy with the number four. Right or left of the keeper, that was 1-0. But he's gone for the extravagant little chip. And there goes the whistle. SCAD 1, Southeastern 0.
That's the end of the first half. SCAD 1, Southeastern 0.
They were great for the first
35
minutes. But the last 10 minutes, they allowed Southeastern to get back in the game. Like I said, the halftime whistle couldn't have come fast enough.
SCAD's next home game is for the men is this coming Saturday at 7 o'clock. It's President's Life evening, and there's going to be free pizza for anybody who attends. This Saturday against Ave Maria at 7 o'clock.
take the spreaders off.
Yeah, I'll take them off and do that.
Half underway. SCAD just do their little routine huddle. See if they can start the way they start the first half, and hopefully don't end the way they don't start the way they ended the first half. Come on, let's go, SCAD. 1-0, and we just kicked off the second half. Southeastern get the game underway. Yeah. Good fit by Phil in the middle. Yes, and it's a free kick. Kicked him 4 or 5 times, and the captain wants to get the game going early again. And he just goes. He plays a great switch. It's a good touch by Oswin. Restarts again. Taylor. And Taylor comes inside to Naeem. And dispossessed. It was a clever little ball, but got dispossessed, and now Southeastern come away with it. Looking a little bit more confident, I must say. Oh, should have taught there, Jordan Chambers. And Southeastern enjoying a little bit, but it's a great ball. And the cross comes in. Oof. Tell you what, it was a good play. Southeastern enjoying a good bit of possession early on. And the number 25 fires a good ball out wide and then manages to get a header on the end of the cross. And it was a good effort. It was good to watch, I must say. But come on, SCAD. And SCAD come away with the ball. Sergio Suarez giving some direction. Gives it to a red shirt. Oh. 13 plays a wasteful ball. Oh, and it's a goal kick. It's a sloppy start by SCAD. And it could quite easily be 1-0. But they get off the hook. And it's a goal kick. Hearing the voice of Tom Melville a little bit more frequently now. Not happy in that dugout. Josh gets a goal kick, Jordan managed to win it, and Naeem picks the second ball up, but just to a red shirt again, but he's been dispossessed by Torin. Referee, they should have had the free kick, and Southeastern come away with the ball. Number 4 makes a good run, but can't be picked out, it's not a good pass. SCAD need to just regroup and calm down. Taylor goes down the line, Trinity flicks on, but it just goes to a red shirt. Has he overhit that? No, the 15 keeps it in, Southeastern. And in the first 2-3 minutes, Southeastern look a different team. Very confident, passing the ball about, fast-paced. And Theo comes away with the ball, gives the ball to Naeem. Goes that wide to Taylor Katsanis. Taylor plays the ball over the top to Tom Melville. Good touch. Referee's all over him. Rightly so. About time. And it's going to be a SCAD free kick. 35 yards out. And the captain once again goes over it. A little too far. Oh, I don't know. I think it's a little bit too far to shoot. But we'll see. Will Osman fancies it. We've got Naeem over as well. And it's going to be Naeem. I think he's just going to float one in. But he goes left of early play. Oh, it's a bad ball. Oh. It's gone out for a throw in. Naeem just overran that. But Will Osman dispossesses the throw. Off he takes off down the left wing. But he's followed by a Southeastern defender. Good layoff. And the cross comes in, but it just finds a red shirt. And Taylor Casanas gets a ball and just gets his toe in and goes to Naeem. And Naeem right to Jordan Chambers. First touch, Jordan Chambers. Just keeps the ball. Doesn't give the ball away very often, Jordan Chambers. Always looks to attack first. And if it's not on, he will happily go back. It's a good challenge. That's a goal kick. Well played, Southeastern. Will Osman not happy. As I was saying, Jordan Chambers, he's naturally attacks. Something I lacked in that position. But he's great to watch in that right full-back position. Southeastern goal kick. Met by the head of Katsanis, and Will Osman brings it down. Plays a ball down the line to Tony Melville, who's one-on-one. Get at him. Oh, the flag stayed down. Theo Angus goes back to Tony. Tonnen lofts the ball in. Oh, and it goes on top of the net. And it's a goal kick to Southeastern. And he's telling Tonnen to push up, so he's going to go long. And it's won by Will Osman. Southeast defender comes at the back of Tony Melville and heads out for a throw-in. Get wide, get wide. And Oliver goes back to Josh. Josh is just going to go to Sergi. Sergi played a bad ball inside. And Southeast can see a bit more possession. Couple more holes opening up now. That's a great ball by the number 25 again. A really good ball. Oh, and Taylor does very well. That's going to be a goal kick. Well, and that is the voice of Gaffer, Coach Melville, shouting at the SCAD defence. He's not best pleased. He has every right, if I'm going to be honest. The last 10 minutes of the first and first 5 minutes of the second, they've been sloppy. SCAD see a bit of possession, going back to Josh Brown. Oliver goes wide to Taylor. That's a good little ball by Jordan. Tries to put Tolan away, but the defender comes across. That's better, that's more positive. I feel like Jordan's getting a little bit frustrated because he came in very deep to get that ball. Probably on the halfway line when he picked it up. But he did play a good little ball. And here comes Southeastern. But luckily it's a bad ball. Jordan Chambers has gone across to the phone. Going to go line. Tom Melville, which one Southeastern defender, but just goes out for another SCAD throw. No whistle goes. Southeastern free kick. Just inside there a half. And they quickly shift the ball out to the right full back. But they drop the ball back into the centre half. Back out to the right full back. Bit more possession for Southeastern. Helping their confidence. They look a different team. It's the last 10 minutes of the first. And this half, they look a complete different team. I don't know if it's SCAD that's gone off a little bit, or if they just raised their game. But SCAD do need to find another gear. Away comes Oliver. Plays a good ball out to Jordan. Bit of a heavy touch. And but here Trincy's away. He plays a good ball into Yanaki. Oh. It was a positive touch, a little bit heavy, and the defender comes across. He was unlucky. Taylor gets the ball out to wide to Will. Tries to dig one in, but he just fires the Southeastern defender. Excuse me. Oh, and that's going to be keepers. But it's still, it is still 1-0 to SCAD. Good win, Taylor. Naeem plays the ball all the way back to Josh. Josh goes wide to Yanaki. Good chest by Yanaki. Second. Good confidence there by Jordan Chambers, showing good confidence, composure. No, referee. Referee gives a cheap free kick there. And Anaki's hurt. I think this could be Daniel. I think he just got caught by studs. Yep, and they've called the trainer on. Bit of cold spray. We'll see. But it's going to be a Southeastern free kick just inside the SCAD's half. And as I said earlier, they are slowly crawling back into this game. They're a much better team, but they're just, you know, they've just gone off the boil a little bit. Cruising around a little bit, maybe. And Anaki stumbles off with the help of Daniel. And that's gonna. And Tony Melville out on the left, and here comes Sese up top. Now SCAD have a job to do defending this free kick. Ball in. It's half cleared. Referee. And we're playing. Taylor Sanders on the left. Plays a long ball. Sassy chases. Calmly done by the number five. Was it? Yeah, the number five. Keeper goes long, Southeastern. Taylor half into the head. And just wins the second ball. Now Naeem. Good ball by Jordan Chambers. Sassy plays a great ball out wide. Will Osmond's first touch is out of his feet. Gets a low cross, but just meets the right fullback of Southeastern. Good pressure. Now SCAD seeing a bit more of the ball. Naeem starting to get back on the ball. I think that may be a problem, because it was the last 10 minutes of the first half where Theo and Naeem were not on the ball as much. And they haven't been at the beginning of the second. And now they start to get on the ball. They're playing good football again. Here comes Southeastern. No, he's not offside. He's on. It's 1-1. Referee. No, referee. Is that for diving? That's never a free kick. But he does give it Southeastern. Sassy sets up his one-man wall again. No, it's a goal kick. It's a goal kick. I must say, Coach Melville's right. The words from Coach Melville, that was the second free kick what was not dealt with by the defenders. Well, seeing Southeastern winning that, they're going to have someone bossing that SCAD, winning them headers. And Josh clears. Jordan gets the flick on, and away goes Will Osmond down the wing. And is he hurt? He stayed down. Is Will Osmond hurt? He looks in pain. Hopefully it's nothing too drastic. SCAD need to get the two centre midfielders on the ball. They're danger men. And right now, they're getting bypassed a little bit. Maybe a couple of too many long balls. They're two key players to SCAD, and when they're not on the ball, well, you can see that since they haven't been on the ball, Southeastern have slowly clawed their way back into the game. Will Osmond hobbles off. Hopefully it's nothing too bad. And it's going to be Seth who comes on. And Jordan's just going to play the keeper the ball back. And he immediately picks up the ball up and chucks out to the left fullback. Left fullback kicked away. Good by Tonnen. That's a SCAD ball, but it goes the other way to Southeastern. Well done, Tonnen. They go inside 17. He's picking a ball. Too much space there. That's a good step by Taylor. Good little touch by Seth. Taylor goes whole. To Sasse, well played. And Chambers gets up wide on the right. Yeah, that's a good spot, but he should have played that on the floor. But he did go in the air, I think around the corner. on the floor, would have been a better ball into Trinity's feet. Run goes into Sasse's feet and back to Chambers. Oh, it's a good one too, it's unlucky. Great challenge, Jordan. It's a throw in for Southeastern, and Southeastern are just in their own half. It's Sasse's on the right, Torren on the left now. There we go, good bit of pressure forces SCAD. There we go, now they make the switch. Trying to get to the left hand side. And that's going to go for a throw in. SCAD deep in the southeastern half. But they do need the goal, another goal to get that cushion. Because right now, southeastern are being a bit of a threat. And just with a one goal lead. Oh, switch would be good here. Kinfield get the switch. Taylor, Jordan Chambers and Akers. That's a good, it's gone out for the throw in. Taylor goes to the line with a throw. Referee. I think the right fullback for Southeastern thought he was playing rugby there for a second. Springs Torren down and he basically jumps on his back. Sasse. It's going to be Sasse. Ooh, it's a good ball but good defending. Good clearance. It's a throw in. Will Oswin out on the bench. Looks like he's getting some treatment. Guess out. Oh, referee! Showing us a little bit of skills there. Let's give a free kick there for you, but excuse me, there wasn't a lot in it. I think it's just the way he went out. Went down, play acting. He's up now, jumping about. That's better header from Taylor. Oh, referee. Oh, and he's chucked out a yellow card for Torren Melville. He's getting a bit whistle happy and card happy right now, the referee. Which he was having a good game. And Gaffer's not too happy with that one. He has every right to be mad. There's never a yellow card. I don't know what the ref is thinking. Oof, I tell you what, not be letting the ball bounce like that, so it's dangerous. Nice Southeastern come away with the ball. And that'll go all the way through to Josh Brown. Got some nice bright yellow gloves on today. Yellow boots. Goes long. He's played the ball to Seth. Oh, he's won the flick on. Good lad. And Sassy comes away. Plays the ball back to Jordan. Jordan's saying that he's in the box, but there's no way the ref's going to give up. Sassy's over the free kick. Come on, SCAD. Let's get a goal. Oof. He forces a save and it goes out to Torin. Hits it low. Oh, and it gets deflected. And it's gone away. Tuck. It's fine. He's fine. Good. Well played. Well played. Taylor picks up Akers. He goes wide to Torin Melville. Marvel chips a good ball down the wing to Jordan. But defender does well. Maybe a bit of a nudge. There wasn't a lot in it. Jordan doesn't seem too happy with it. So Suarez gets a touch, lays off to Sasse. Sasse goes left back, but Jordan made a great run there, Chambers. Right, it's a good call by Jordan Chambers. Now Taylor gets the ball out left. Plays it to Jordan. Good little turn. Plays a great ball into Naeem. Good touch. Sassy's got plenty of room to shoot. Strikes one. Oh, it's a great goal. Great goal by Sassy Zaretta. As soon as he gets into that space with his left foot, it's always going to be dangerous.
SCAD
has slowly got themselves back in this half, and they did need that goal. I must be honest, they needed it. It's a very good goal, though. Probably 20 yards out. Gets a ball on his left foot. Great strike and puts it into the right hand side. While the keeper's left, the right hand side from where I'm watching. And what a great strike that was by Izzaretta. How are we doing, mate? The Southeastern get us back underway. It's now SCAD 2, Southeastern 0. I can't believe the linesman's kept his flag down. The ball was about... Oh, Naeem dives in a little bit there. Don't get sloppy, SCAD. And if this bounces, Seth's in. And it does. Just push it. Going your way. Oh, that's unlucky. He just couldn't quite get the ball out of his feet there, Seth. We got a little baby in the crowd. He's not too happy. Tantrum. I think it might be because he's a Southeastern fan. He's not happy with the way he's playing. Back to the game. It's Sergio Suarez on the ball. Plays a switch to Oliver. And Oliver to Taylor. Good ball by Tony Melville to Taylor. Now I've seen Taylor attacking, oof, and he's tried to push Trincy in. Good pressure by SCAD, which wins on the ball back in a dangerous area. It's Seth, shoots, but it just goes into the finds the keeper's hands. Well done though, very positive there. That's better from SCAD. Keep goes long, it finds the feet of Phil. It's a SCAD throwing on the halfway line. We've got about 20 minutes left. It's SCAD 2. Southeastern 0. Quick recap. First 35 minutes of the first half belonged all to SCAD. And 10 minutes to go, Southeastern slowly got themselves back into the game. and they've seen the best of the possession in the last 10 minutes of the first half, and they had a couple of great, great chances. One golden opportunity where their strikers tried to chip Josh Brown, who's 6'4", by the way, and probably he was only about 12 yards out, so I don't know what he was thinking. But anyway, they kept that momentum and took it into the second half, and the first 10 minutes of the second half, they've seen great possession, but now it's SCAD. And it's SCAD now is picking the game up again. And they just scored, and their pressure, it was deserved a goal because they were putting Southeastern on the back foot again. But back to the game now, we've got 19 minutes left, but it's a Southeastern free kick, probably 35 yards out. It's too far to shoot, surely. We'll see. Oh, it looks like he's set himself up for a cross. Penalty area ball, this. Always the dangerous area. Oh, he's got an 18-yard box instead. Seth's one-on-one now. The defender does well. And it goes into the keeper's feet. Southeastern plays a long ball up. And this time it is won by a SCAD colour. Oh, that's put with a little bit of pressure. Time point. He's in. What's up? That's right. The ref was right there. He was all over Seth's shirt. And the referee spotted it. And now we've got a free kick. And yeah, I must say, a dangerous position. It's very central. Someone needs to shoot, it needs to be hit very well. But he goes quick, so I say, out wide to John Chambers. He goes down the wing to Seth. Seth's won a free kick again. We've got. Sasse's over there, but Phil ventures across as well. He's gone to the back post. Oof, and Oliver was there. Oh. Southeastern free kick in their own 18-yard box. Left. Score still 2-0 SCAD. Good turn by Jordan there. Number 10. Oh, he's falling a little bit heavy there. He's fine. Just getting a breather. Oh, and the referee's got a free kick. It's interesting. I can't be judging it from here. 60 yards away from play. Oh, he didn't get the free kick. It's a SCAD throw. Sessa brings the ball with a great touch on the edge of the box. But Southeastern carry the ball out. Name. With a great little handball there. Thought he was going to get away with that one. Oh, that's going to roll through to the SCAD keeper. Time, good. Good talking, Jordan. Let's go to the left format. SCAD's defence sitting deep there. They need to get up. They've been ball watching a little bit too much. My liking tonight, the SCAD's defence. The left winger for Southeastern plays the ball. Southeastern on the edge of number 20, shoots, And it's a goal. It's a goal, Southeastern. It's down to bad defending again. It's second ball comes out. They're so slow at getting out to the guy. I can't take anything away from the finish because.
Assisted by number four, Ashton Hicks. Goal by number 20, Christian.
Number
Bohr.
20 does get out of his feet and he bends it right into the far right hand corner. It's a great finish, but from a defensive point of view, it's terrible. First of all, it started from the SCAD number 8 safety. He dives in. And then for the second ball, no one just got out to the guy. He did have time to get onto his favourite right foot. Like I said, the finish was fantastic, but it's not good enough. Now we've got 15 minutes left now, and Southeastern, I'm sure, are going to make a game of this. I'm sure the SCAD dugout is not happy. SCAD just need to dig in and get this result and go to work in practice in the week. Got another game Saturday. Need to get in tomorrow, regroup. Oh. Good pressure by Chambers. But he does give a free kick away. Referee hurrying him up. It's that time, ref. It goes long. Nice, Jordan winning the header. Get wide, get wide, get wide, get wide. Now it's Sasse attacking. He's going to always go inside in his left foot, and he does. And they allow it. Referee. There's a sniper up on the roof taking Sasse out there. Don't get me wrong, he got fouled, but I don't think they didn't need to execute the forward roll after being fouled. And he's up over the free kick now. Oh no, he doesn't take it. Maybe he is hurt. It's Naeem plays the ball in. It's met by the defence. Sasse wins. And out come Southeastern with the ball. Southeastern. Oh, they're asking for a foul. I can't tell from here. I'm going to say no. It's a SCAD throwing, but it's deep in their own half. Can't dig in, SCAD. 12 minutes to go. Let's get this game won. Referee. SCAD need to get up. They're sitting a bit deep. We need to squeeze up. Can't be sitting in this one goal lead. And here comes Southeastern again. That's going to go to the goalkeeper. Take your time, Josh. And he goes long, looking for Jordan. I'm sure he's had a lot of slip, but I'm sure. And here comes Seth. Out wide, Torren. Puts a good ball across, but it goes into the keeper hand, the Southeastern. And there is a few holes starting to develop now, I can see. Jordan Chambers, great header. But here comes Southeastern again. Good defense. Jordan again. Doesn't look too happy. Oof, and it's the same guy, number 20, gets on his right foot in roughly the same position, maybe another a couple of yards out this time, but Josh Brown picks a ball up this time. It wasn't quite as far in the corner. It's good soccer. And a bit of ping pong ahead of us there. Naeem. Oh no, it's Jordan's down. I think he may have a bit of cramp. No, he's dead leg. That'll be him for the night. Just took a knee to the. I could tell what's happened there. He is getting up. I just think he had a bit of a knee nudge. Let's see how bad it is. You'll feel it in the morning, though. I guarantee that. SCAD get us back underway. And Oliver plays a great ball out wide. There's Areta trying to outskill. Keep the ball. He plays a good ball to serve. Beats the man, but the flag goes up and it's a goal kick. Just under 10 minutes left. It is still 2-1. It was a good header by Sergio Suarez. And away comes Taylor Katsanis with the ball on the left-hand side. We need to clear that. Oh, and SCAD feeling the pressure a little bit. SCAD need to grind in here to get this result. So let's see, hobbling along. Get wide. Go on, Chambers. Get into that space. Good challenge. Good. Oh, referee. I've got to say, he's got it wrong there. It's a great challenge. Great challenge. But hits a SCAD ball. Take your time here, boys. Wide, Katsanis goes inside the surf, plays a good ball back. Katsanis continues his run. He does still have the ball, plays across. Oh, I thought he was going to drop in. 8 minutes left. SCAD just need, as I said, they just need to grind this one out. Get their rest, get their ice baths. Sleep well the next two nights, and then we'll be back involved on Saturday against Ave Maria. Oh, he's broke the line. Southeastern's players across. Sergio Suarez is. Oh, he's been beat. Oh, and I tell you what. Great challenge, Jordan. Great challenge by John Chambers. Play the line, man on. Once again, the SCAD defence get caught out. And they get off very lightly there. SCAD on the back foot in the last few minutes. They need it, they can't. He's right. Tom Melville shouting, don't ball watch. And I tell you what, he's correct. They're ball watching. They're sitting very deep now. They don't need this for the next few minutes. Something to get a shot off. Take your time. Take your time, Josh. The referee's stopped the clock. Right, he's gonna. Well done, Josh. Good experience there. Keep him there. Keep him pinned in. Silly! It's a silly free kick. Southeastern come with the ball one more time. Just over 5 minutes left. They've played a ball. Let's keep hers. Time, Josh. Time. It's still. Southeastern coming with the ball again. Good lad, Chambers. Relax, 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 relax. Don't pick it up. Don't pick it up. Just crazy. Goal kick up. Seth a bit hard done by there. Josh has got his kicks are going to the smallest guy on the field. Gotta be aiming for a bigger guy. I'm not taking nothing against Seth there. He's just smaller. We got a big guy in there holding it up a little bit. No, you're not too happy there. But he's been quiet himself in the last 20 minutes or so. He did start getting in the game and it just died out a little bit again. And so that's a problem when they don't have their two centre midfields on the ball. SCAD dies a little bit. They're both very creative. They need to get them on the ball more. And straight to Steph again. I tell you, he's one of I say not to kick the ball to him because he's small, but I tell you what, he's won every single header. Give it him. SCAD just taking the time here. 3:49 left. They've gone lined into Jordan this time. Time. And Theo comes away with the ball. That was a great ball. Good touch by Seth. Bit tricky. Oh, he has a shot. Unlucky. Unlucky. And there's just over 3 minutes left. Hopefully SCAD just grind this one out. This is it. Good lad, Naeem. Well played, Jordan. Oh, what a ball as well. It's a goal kick. It's 2 minutes, just over 2 minutes left on the clock, and it's an exciting end. And they go long. Talk to him. That's gone out for a corner. SCAD need to defend this. It's 2 minutes left. Pick up. Right now I can see one, two. Two not picked up in the box. Goes deep. There's just over a minute left. The ball's still deep inside the SCAD's half. Oh. Don't know what the guy was thinking there. He's trying to play a ball with the outside of his right foot. He's just give it a toey, and that's just what SCAD needed. That'll run the clock down.
One minute.
And just 40 odd seconds left at Southeastern. This is going to be their last attack. This guy cut it out. And this could be it. Just over 30 seconds left. Yeah, and that's going to be the game. That's going to be the game. No rush to get this. Sanis goes the line. Jordan's in. He'll just run the ball. Oh, he's gone for it. 20 seconds game. We count the last 10 seconds down. It's got 5 seconds left. They're going to break. Oh, one. And that's it. And SCAD do hold on. They made hard work of that. But they do get the win in the first conference game. SCAD 2, Southeastern 1.
Next game for SCAD men will be Saturday.
And we'll be back on Saturday against Ave Maria.
Residence life night. Free